Thank you. Good morning, everyone.
Good morning.
I'm Peter Simpson, and I'm very happy to be with you today. Our service, of course, is the Holy Eucharist flat plan. Bless the Lord, who forgiveth all our sins. Almighty God, unto whom all hearts are open, all desires known, and from whom no secrets are hid, cleanse the thoughts of our hearts by the inspiration of thy Holy Spirit, that we may perfectly love thee and worthily magnify thy holy name, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Hear where our Lord Jesus Christ says, thou shalt love the Lord thy God with all thy heart, with all thy soul, and with all thy mind. This is the first and great command. And the second is like unto it, thou shalt love thy neighbor as thyself. On these two commands hang all the law and the prophets.
Michael prophesied about the same time as Isaiah, at the end of the 8th century B.C.E. He focuses particularly on the social injustices of a period turbulent political upheaval. Today's reading springs from the hope of a restoration of the Davidic monarchy after the exile. From Bethlehem, David's city, will come a new ruler, a shepherd. His origin is traced to ancient times, to the days of David. Verse 3 explains the delay in the restoration and full return of the exiles. The Messiah will restore the life and well-being of the people. Matthew adapted Micah 5:2 as a prophecy of Jesus' birth in Bethlehem. A reading from the 5th chapter of the book of Micah, beginning with the second verse. You, O Bethlehem, Ephrathah, who are one of the little clans of Judah, from you shall come forth from me one who is to rule in Israel, whose origin is from old, from ancient days. Therefore he shall give them up until the time when she who is in labor has brought forth. Then the rest of his kindred shall return to the people of Israel. And he shall stand and feed his flock in the strength of the Lord, in the majesty of the name of the Lord his God. And they shall live secure, for now he shall be great to the end of the earth, and he shall be the one of peace. The word of the Lord. The Hebrew prophets always reminded Israel that sacrifices were only to be a manifestation of obedience to all of the law. The author interprets the song as spoken by Jesus as a call to the abolition of the sacrificial system. The old order, the old covenant, is abolished, and a new is established. The sacrifice that God asks is obedience to one's own will to God's will. Jesus offers his body on Hebrews terms, his whole life, in self-dedication to God's will. By this self-offering as a sacrificial victory, we have been sanctified, verse 10, ceremonially cleansed and made holy. So the salvific meaning of Jesus' incarnation is found in the reconciliation of humanity to God, Jesus. A reading from the 10th chapter of the book of Hebrews, beginning with the 5th. When Christ came into the world, he said, "Sacrifice is an offering you have not desired, but a body you have prepared for me. In burnt offerings and sin offerings you have taken no pleasure." Then I said, "See, God, I have come to do your will, O God, in the scroll of the book you have written in me." When he said above, "You have neither desired nor taken pleasure in sacrifices and offerings and burnt offerings and sin offerings. These are offered according to law." Then he added, "See, I have come to do your will." He abolishes the first in order to establish the second. And it is God's will that we have been sanctified through the offering of the body of Jesus Christ once for all. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
to the Christ, and glory to Luke.
Glory to Jesus.
In those days, Mary set out and went with haste to the day and town and the country, where she entered the house of Zechariah and greeted Elizabeth. When Elizabeth heard Mary's greeting, the child leaped in her womb. And Elizabeth was filled with the Holy Spirit and exclaimed with a loud voice, "Blessed are you among women, and blessed is the fruit of your womb. And why has this happened to me, that the mother of my Lord comes to me? For as soon as I heard the sound of your greeting, the child in my womb leaped for joy. And blessed is she who believed that there would be a fulfillment of what was spoken of her by the Lord." And Mary said, "My soul magnifies the Lord, and my spirit rejoices in God, my Savior. For he has looked with favor on the lowliness of his servant. Surely, from now on, all generations will call me blessed. For the Mighty One has done great things for me, and holy is his name. His mercy is for those who fear him from generation to generation. He has shown strength with his arm. He has scattered the proud in the thoughts of their hearts. He has brought down the powerful from their thrones and lifted up the lowly. He has filled the hungry with good things and sent the rich away empty. He has helped his servant Israel in remembrance of his mercy, according to the promise he made to our ancestors, to Abraham and to his descendants forever." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, O Christ. Thank you.
sumptuous dinner, you know, for friends coming over for Christmas. And it's a lot of work. And she says, you know, sweetheart, to her six-year-old, when we get to the place where there's grace, would you say grace, please? Oh, mommy, I don't know how to do that. I don't know what to say. Just say something you've heard mommy say. Okay, so gets in time for grace. The girl says, oh, God, why did I invite all these people? Anyway, ascribe to the Lord the honor of his name, bring gifts, and come into his school. It is very right and our bounden duty that we should at all times and in all places give thanks unto thee, O Lord, Holy Father, Almighty, everlasting God, because thou hast sent thy beloved Son to redeem us from sin and death, and make us heirs in him of everlasting life, that when he shall come again in power and great triumph to judge the world, we may, without shame or fear, rejoice to behold his appearing. Therefore, with angels and archangels, and with all the company of heaven, we laud and magnify thy glorious name, evermore praising thee and singing,
and also that we in all thy whole church may be made one
with whom and in whom, in the unity of the Holy Ghost, all honor and glory be unto thee, O Father Almighty, world without end. And now, as our Savior Christ has taught us, we are bold to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come. Thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. Christ, our Passover, was sacrificed for us. Thank you. ever-living God, we most heartily thank thee for that thou dost feed us in these holy mysteries with the spiritual food of the most precious body and blood of thy Son, our Savior, Jesus Christ, and dost assure us thereby of thy favor and goodness towards us, and that we are buried members and corporate in the mystical body of thy Son, the blessed company of all faithful people, and are also heirs through hope of thy everlasting kingdom. And we humbly beseech thee, O Heavenly Father, so to assist us with thy grace, that we may continue in that holy fellowship and do all such good works as thou hast prepared for us to walk in. Through Jesus Christ our Lord, to whom with thee and the Holy Ghost be all honor and glory, world without end. Amen. Peace of God, which passes all understanding, keep your hearts and minds in the knowledge and love of God and of his Son, Jesus Christ our Lord. And the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit be among you and remain with you forever.